Hi there, I'm NBC2 meteorologist Jason Dunning, and for today's edition, I've brought with me the single most important thing that weather brings us. Water. Or, in the world of weather, rain. Of course, it's not raining right now, but here in Southwest Florida, we definitely see our fair share of rain, especially during the rainy season in the summertime. Without rain, we would not be able to live here on planet Earth. All of this would be a desert. So we need rain to give us fresh water to drink, to help us grow plants and food, and also to keep everything looking green and lush. Believe it or not, even on a day like this with clear blue skies and sunshine, there is water all around me right now. You can't see it because it's in the form of water vapor. It's a gas, the gas form of H2O. So how do we get from water vapor to liquid water? That happens through a process we know as condensation. Here's a perfect example using a nice cold glass of refreshing water that you might drink like this on a nice sunny hot day. We actually have condensation taking place right now. Can you see it? See how the water is building up on the outside of the glass? Now that's not water coming in from the inside. What's happening is the cold water inside the glass is cooling the air on the outside, and the water vapor turns into liquid water, and that is condensation taking place. The atmosphere works the same way. The sun heats the earth, that warm air rises like a hot air balloon, and also rising with it, water vapor, which eventually condenses into cloud droplets, and then we get precipitation. Let's go into the kitchen, I'll show you how it works and how you can make your own rain experiment. All right, we've made it to the kitchen on our quest to discover how rain forms. Check this out. This container here represents the ocean, or in the case of Southwest Florida, the Gulf of Mexico. And just like water vapor can turn into liquid water can also turn back into water vapor. It's actually happening right now. You can't see it because it's transforming into a gas, but this final piece of the process is what we call evaporation. So let's put that all together and show you how to make rain. I've got a little experiment to do that. Let me show you what I've got, and you could do this at home too with the help of your parents or grandparents or guardians. So let's see what we got here. We have a dropper in this case. This is a turkey baster. We also have cotton balls, okay? We've got our tub of water, the ocean or the Gulf of Mexico, and I use blue food coloring to change it blue so it's a little bit easier to see. And I've got a glass jar and a plastic cup with a hole cut at the bottom. So let's put that all together and make it rain. So I've got this experiment we're gonna do here. We've got the jar. This is gonna be where we live, inside the jar here at the bottom of the jar. That's planet Earth. This is gonna represent the atmosphere. The cotton balls, those are clouds. So let's put this on top of the atmosphere. So you have a nice sunny day so far where you've got these puffy cumulus clouds, as you may have learned with Chief Meteorologist Allison Ray. She talked about the cloud types. And we know also that clouds are just billions and billions of tiny water droplets. And eventually to make rain, you've got these water droplets that continue to develop and build up inside the cloud. And those little water droplets collide and sort of congeal together. And eventually what happens as gravity continues to build, you can see what happens as the cloud gets heavy enough, the water starts to fall out as rain. And we've got a nice little drizzle, nice little downpour starting to develop. And after the rain falls, it streams back into our oceans, our rivers, our lakes, and eventually, ultimately, this all ends up back in the ocean. So all of this, what we saw here in our little atmosphere, in our jar, it's all part of a perfectly balanced cycle that we call the water cycle. So let's review. Water vapor evaporates into the air, condenses to make clouds, and then falls as precipitation or rain back to the earth. Here's a fun fact. A single droplet of water may spend up to 3,000 years in the ocean before it moves on to another part of the water cycle. 3,000 years. So the next time you take a drink of water, think about this. The water you're drinking has been here almost since the earth was formed, almost 4 billion years ago. That's how old the water is. And it all just keeps getting recycled in that process that we know as the water cycle.